You need three measurements for a full arch. You need your width, your minimum height, and your maximum height.
This is a window here that has a track at the bottom. Okay, so there's a track down here, and then it's got a track up top. So it's an arched window that has tracks. Or arched windows that have tracks where you could fit a full-size screen into it, you're going to spring-load the screen with this right here, okay? They're called leaf springs. This leaf spring, when compressed, will take up about an eighth of an inch, okay? So when you get your measurements for an arch, you're gonna need three measurements, okay? You're gonna need your width measurement, you're gonna need your maximum height measurement, which is that, and then you're gonna need the minimum height measurement, which is this here, okay? When you get the width measurement for a window where the screen fits into tracks, you want to be sure that you measure this width, and this width. So if you take the width measurement from the inside of the track to the inside of the track, so that width measurement, say it's 34 5/8. Well, if you deduct an eighth or even deduct a 3/16 off of that, that'll give you a good width to work with, okay? You don't want to make the thing too tight where it won't fit, and that's why you do your multiple measurements, because whatever your narrowest width is what you want to use. So when you measure for a track, see up there how it's got that track, okay? So a piece of framing can go behind right up in there, okay? And then the framing comes down, follow my finger, comes down all the way down into here, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna measure it to here, and then we're going to measure to the bottom of that track there, okay? The bottom of that track, and we're gonna add an eighth of an inch. That'll enable the frame to get up into this track some, okay? And it'll allow for the spring there, that leaf spring, to be able to fit up in there. So when you measure up to this track for leaf springs, okay, you're gonna measure to right here, okay? Right to that piece right there, okay? And then you're gonna add an eighth of an inch for your leaf spring. See, there's plenty of room up in there. So the eighth of an inch for your leaf spring. Okay, so see how the tape there is in the bottom of that track, comes on up the side here, comes on up. Then, see it's 65 7/16. Okay, 65 7/16, we're gonna add an eighth of an inch to that, and that's what's gonna give you this outside leg here for your solar screen, okay? That's gonna be that right there, your minimum height, okay? For your maximum height, which is gonna be the center height of the arch screen, see, I'm sitting down into the bottom track down there. Okay. Comes up, 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 up. Okay. So we're at 71 and say 71 3/8 ought to cut it. Okay. So 71 1/4 roughly comes to the bottom of that channel there. 71 3/8 would be a good fit up into that channeling. Okay. So that channeling, we've got plenty of room up in there, okay? So there's plenty of room up in there. So it's nice to make the center of this arch screen fit up in there nice and tight. So as a hardware option for your arch screens, you can get the arch screens with the leaf springs at the top, and when you do that, it'll come with two of those, 3/4 inch screw, okay? And then a flush clip. And they're always color matched to match the framing. It's up to you whether or not you want to use it or not. I recommend that you do. It keeps the screen pushed up against the window, and it keeps the screen from possibly coming out.